Hello everybody, welcome back to a new video. It's Gina here and welcome to my art corner. For today I have something for you that I think I only did really once on this channel, and it's a more like a real-time kind of video, really just a little bit sped up, like you can't really tell that it's sped up almost. And when I thought I would try it, because I've seen some art YouTubers post longer videos now, and I thought I would try it too, why not? You know, you never know, just try it and maybe it's good, why not? And the very first video that I actually did in this kind of real-time video kind of thingy was a gouache video. It was a hand practice, and literally I drew an hand, so it's just not like a practicing for my hand, but practicing hands. And I don't know anymore how good it was, but I think back then I didn't see that much longer videos, like Drawing with Waffles, of course. And she's amazing. I love her videos. I really need to binge watch them, because I made a little, like, I could say break with watching longer videos right now. And I have to watch some videos from my subscription box again and everything. But I thought I would try it now too, because as I've said, there are more, like, I don't know what happened, but there are some kind of longer videos right now with art, and I think it's great, and well, let's try it too. So here I am, and I didn't sketch this in the video. I'm still like, I don't know why, it's really funny when I sketch digitally. I don't mind if it's sketchy and messed up or anything, because it's really easy to fix. But in traditional art, I just don't know. Maybe it's the camera, maybe I'm feeling too pressured to like make it all perfect. I don't know even why, because not even my inking or the coloring are really perfect, and I'm one person that, like, I want it to look good, but I'm someone that is like, nothing can be really 100% perfect. You will always find something, like, at least I am like that, and I think a lot of artists are like that, that when they are finishing something, and at first they are super, like, proud of it, and then look at it, and think, okay, how did I not see this mistake and that mistake, and I could have made this better or this darker, and so on. The list goes on. You probably know it yourself, like, let's be honest, it's just the way it is. Always like finding the mistakes after you have finished it, and just like really wanna cry because it's not how you wanted it. And as you can see, probably if you have watched any other video of mine, I tried again this two angle thingies, like I inked it from the side so you could see a little bit better, because when I ink from above you can see it, but not that exactly, like you see a little bit more how I ink, and I really slowed it up so little that it's almost absolutely the speed that I actually ink. So for everyone who thinks inking is fast, nope, it is not. And I didn't even record the second inking. Like, I don't know guys what you are like used to when inking, but I mostly ink it first, let it dry a little bit, erase the sketch underneath it, and then go in and enhance and stronger and make the lines stronger. I really want to have a little bit more dynamic in my line art, so it's mostly what I do if I'm not doing it like digitally. And I'm super sorry, but I feel like I have something in my trough, and yeah. But yeah, it will be fun. We'll put some music in between if I don't have like talking for almost 33 minutes. And I'm just really wanting this to be a chatty video, and yeah, I hope you will enjoy it. And also, this is, again, if you haven't watched my other videos that I uploaded, my OC Satomi. And Satomi was one of my first OCs, but I never drew my original characters this much after one another. Like, normally I would jump between, at the beginning especially, I would jump between drawing this original character and then jumping on fan art, or like drawing another original character. And this time it's like really, I'm super proud because I kind of worked on my original character. I still need a backstory for her and everything. The only thing that I have is that I'm thinking about that she's not really a redhead. You will see later that she has red hair. And I'm thinking about maybe she just likes it and like that's why she colors her hair red. I'm still thinking about backgrounds and everything, but I'm so glad like on Instagram I asked if people would like more original characters are they just liking the like illustrations with random characters without really seeing the characters more often. And I'm quite glad that most of you want to see original characters. And if you're not following me on Instagram yet but want to see more of my art, then you totally should go there, because I upload normally mostly almost every second, third day. It really depends on what is happening in my life right now. But yeah, mostly I upload as much as I can and not just like once or twice a week. Okay, I will be honest. This week or last week, it depends when I'm uploading this video. I didn't have time to draw yet because I was just so exhausted. I was like, yeah, how should I call it? Like renovating a little bit my bedroom slash art room, because my studio and my bedroom are in one. It's not that big, but it's enough. It's enough and I love it, and I'm still not all finished, but I'm really glad, and I will see if I someday will make a art room video just showing you the places where my art related stuff is. But I will see. I'm not sure, to be honest, because I'm all shy with things like this. And I was also thinking about doing some live streams someday here or on Twitch, I don't know. But yeah, I will have to overcome my really awkward shyness. And you know, I'm still proud that I'm actually doing voiceovers. I still remember my first video where I did a voiceover, and the funniest thing happened there. I was like, please forget me or something like that. And I just then realized what I said and I was like, no, don't forget me. I remember that still so much because I was laughing at myself because of the stupid mistake. It was so, oh gosh, I was really like, at the beginning, what was really funny is that I kind of wasn't that nervous drawing on camera, because it wasn't my really like, how should I say it, mostly I drew fan art at the beginning, not just fan art, but like trying to draw the image that I saw one-on-one, or a little bit in my style, drawing them, like coloring them in my style. But after a while I started this original fan art and original art, illustrations and everything. And even now, after like, let's say 2 years, 3 years, I don't know anymore, I'm still nervous characters. Like, I feel always like I have to do really, really, really amazing. And now that I see these differences between my old art and new art, I'm super proud, I'm super happy, but I still feel sometimes like there still could be even more and better ways and everything. Like, I'm trying to improve. I will try to make different videos and really hope that you guys like it and everything. And I really hope that you like once in a while something that isn't that speed up. Like you can see here also, I'm coloring the skin and I have it sped up a little bit, so it's not like super slow because this is mixed media paper, and on mixed media paper you have to be really careful that it's not that streaky at the end. And also I have another paper, you can see it a little bit at the top, because I didn't want the marker, like the ink, to go through and have it on another page. So I always put the paper between them, so if it leaks through it's alright because I have a protection between. And yeah, this is also the Mixed Media Kensen XL sketchbook. Gosh, I think it's my fourth one. Like, I love the sketchbook, but I think they changed something on it. Like, the cover, it's so interesting. I don't even know how to describe it. It's kind of really this smooth, but also, like, it would be a little bit thicker and almost like it's not really sticky, but it's so interesting. Like, I don't know, guys, do you have any new mixed media sketchbook from Kensen, the XL one? Please let me know if the covers from yours is also a little bit different than the old ones, because the old ones were also thick, but they were just like this really really just thick paper. Of course they stands everything, but it wasn't this, like, I have a pencil that has the same like feeling outside of it, and I was just really irritated what they did, probably. But yeah, I still love the paper, and even if I have to admit, I have so many sketchbooks that I'm working on, and also working on single sheets of paper again with markers and watercolor paper, that I think the sketchbook will take a long time before I finish it, or I really have to work a lot on it and use this little bit more, even if it's a little bit more expensive, more like a sketchbook, like not just like drawings like this. And yeah, I'm just rambling on. I think I will talk through this because I tend to ramble. But yeah, I really like sketchbooks. I have some of them filled. I have quite some sketchbook tours, so if you're interested, guys, in my older art or like filled sketchbooks, just go to my playlist. I have a playlist with all of the sketchbooks that I've recorded already and put in there. And I think I have my oldest sketchbook. It wasn't really a sketchbook, but I used it like that. And it's just so crazy. I really have to talk about this. I think I mentioned this already in some videos, but when I was smaller, like a kid, a teenager and everything, I always loved to draw. I really, really loved to draw. I remember that I pretty much really drew or sketched already when I was really small, like every kid does and everything. But it stayed with me so much, and the crazy thing is, when Disney, like, I drew a lot of Disney, tried to redraw the characters and everything, and then anime and manga came, and I was just really, like, into it and trying it. And back in the days, like, man, I sound old, but I had this, like, already then I had a phone that could take pictures, but, like, you know, it wasn't that great back in the days. And, like, some anime was going on TV, and I was just like, oh, I really like this. So I was, like, trying to take a picture and drawing the character from the picture that was actually a really, really bad picture or photo. And I always only drew what I saw. And my father was sometimes like, why don't you add all of the head, or why don't you add something to it? And I was just like, I can do that. I can't do that because I only can draw what I see. And I was just like, totally making myself worse than I was, I could say, because I didn't even believe in me that I could draw it, like, at least try it. And after a while, I was trying, like, okay, changing things up, adding own things and everything, but I always ended up again with drawing, sketching what I saw. I wanted to make a small picture that I saw in a magazine, draw it bigger, or the other way around. And I wanted to see if I could replicate it in some kind of way. And some things I really could. I have old drawings that I'm still super proud of it, that I pretty much like do it, but it wasn't really mine. In some kind of way it was, because I wasn't like tracing it, like printing the picture out and tracing the lines and everything. But I was looking at it and trying, even if I have to admit, it wasn't good that I actually copied someone's art. It was like, really, look, why is it like that? How is the shapes and everything? And even if I sometimes use like this grid method, like you take a paper, make a grid on the original and on your paper, and then go in and draw it in, like, I have a very old drawing book where there were also this grid, and as a kid I didn't just get what they wanted to do with that, to be honest. I was just like, okay, why are there grids there and what should that help and everything? Now I know it, and it would be great if there has been a better, like, explanations. But yeah, coloring, I really tried to combine the colors. I was thinking, like, okay, how should I make this color? How could I draw this, or how could I color this? And before I got my markers, my very, very first marker was actually from a friend. It was the Copic 00E00, I believe. It was my very, very first Copic. I still have it. And she got it from, I don't know, I think Daisuke? It was also this magazine kind of thing. And she didn't use it, she didn't need it, so she sent it to me, and I was in love. I was instantly in love, because I always had so much trouble drawing nice skin with colored pencils, and I used to draw a lot with colored pencils. I really should start, like, using colored pencils again, or in combination with markers more. I have a ton of markers now. I bought always the cheap one, and even the Copic markers that I have that aren't empty, I have a lot that are empty already, are from Japan. My friend was there in Japan, and let's be honest, it's much cheaper. So I told her to bring me some, and that's the only way that I actually had so much Copic markers, because in Germany they are quite a bit expensive, like, holy moly, it's a lot. And yeah, I wasn't used to drawing my own or original. And thanks to the same friend that gave me the Copic marker, I slowly started. And not just like thanks to her, I started even doing these videos. And slowly, because I watched other YouTubers, I still remember that Art a la Carte, or Valerie, I think her name was, if I'm not wrong, and Rambutan Illustrations. Both of them were actually the first YouTubers that I've really watched that made voiceovers and made their original characters. And I was really just like thinking, if they can do that, I want to try that too. And at first I started with original fan art and slowly got into trying to draw my own characters. And I think where I really changed what I drew Of course, I still do fan art, and even now I draw sometimes fan art because it's just something that is part of my life. I was like thinking, okay, the first really time where something changed for me was the very first Inktober. And the very first Inktober was pretty suddenly, I could say. I was just like going shopping with my mother and I was like, okay, I want to buy ink. And I just started. I started with a sketchbook, with inks that I had at home, with the black ink that I bought, and really made the small starting drawings. Taking references, but all original. There were a lot of animals, there were a lot of darker things and different things, and I didn't even think that I would pull through it, but I actually took part of Inktober 3 years. And I know right now there's something going on with Jake Parker and Inktober and everything. And even if this wasn't going around, I don't know if I could participate this year. I will be honest. I made it like 3. I think that's a nice number. But I don't know if I can make it a 4th year. Like, not just that, but I still have things to go through with my eye. I will have some appointment in October, and in October I have to go to my eyes doctor again. So yeah, I don't know if with all the stress that will happen in October again, if I can do Inktober again, but if I maybe I will redraw some old Inktober drawings, I don't know, I will be honest with you guys. And let me know in the comments, will you participate in Inktober? I really don't know, I think a lot of people won't do actually the Inktober things. Like really, I don't quite know, something happened that Jake Parker somehow made problems for another artist or something like that because of Inktober. I don't quite know what is happening. If you want to know more, just check it out yourself. I will have to check it out too. But I'm just like, I don't know what is happening. This year is crazy, but at the same time I'm kind of happy because two artists that I followed and still know from the DeviantArt time are back on Instagram, and I'm just really glad because it's like meeting old friends that you didn't see in such a long time, and seeing them back again and doing art is just really nice, to be honest. And I really try to think about nice things too and look at nice things, even if this year is not that nice, not that amazing. Like everyone thought, yeah, 2020 will be our year. Well, no. But it can always get better, and it will, like, it's just a year. Next year could be better. And oh my gosh, this voiceover got all over the place, but I'm just really like just chatting with you guys, and I hope you like it. And as you can see, I changed the angle again because I use a little bit of colored pencils. I really want to try to make this more again and not even shade with markers, but like have the really flat color with markers and then go in with colored pencils, because it's so great. You don't have to worry about the whiteness of the paper, looking through the colored pencils, or like pushing like crazy so it won't be seen. And it's just really a great idea. If you don't want to see the whiteness of the paper, like, you know, when you color with colored pencils, you sometimes have this little dots, white dots, before you really push into it or use like solvents or how they're called. You can use watercolor as a base or markers. They don't even have to be expensive markers. Buy a really cheap set of markers. with colors that you know that you use more often in your drawings and just use them as a base. It's so amazing. Like at the beginning, I really started out with pretty much, I think, only skin colors as markers, and then slowly I got some markers with different colors, but I mostly really just use them as a base color. And I really want to go back to that, and I want to draw more of my original characters. I want to redraw more. I actually wanted to redraw so much in this year, and somehow it's already September. Where did the year go? I mean, this year was so crazy already, and we are September? Like, how? I can't get it how this year actually flew by so fast. It's just crazy. And I made a lot of art, and I could have made much more already. And, oh gosh, this year is just like, I don't know, for me, to be honest, this year started already like this in December, so like through December being all crazy and continuing in January, and then soon in February or March we had this COVID thing going on. Yeah, I think we all need a break, but to be honest, it's just crazy. It's crazy how fast time, it was just the beginning of the year, and now we are pretty much almost at the end. Like, let's be honest, from September there aren't that many months anymore, and it's just so crazy, guys. It's crazy how everything is happening and everything, but still, at least I try to stay positive as much as I can, because what other things stay if you aren't, or like, not trying to look at the little positive things? Of course, many bad things happen, but honestly, there's always some bad things happening on the world. And I'm trying to be here again, this all, like, stay positive kind, but I'm just really trying it myself. It's not that easy often, because things happen and they are not nice, they are not good. But you have to do the best as you can and try to make the best out of it, I could say. And yeah, I'm really interested, guys. If you're still here and not like thinking, oh my gosh, shut up, because of your accent, and because, what do I know, maybe you don't like if people talk like that much. I didn't think I would talk through the end, or till the end, I mean. But yeah, do you like videos like this? Do you like it to see a little bit more realish time videos where the artist is talking with you about different things? You could also give me some suggestions. What do you want that I talk about? Should I talk even more about the progress? Because I was pretty much about just chatting with you guys about different things, but I could also talk a little bit more about what I'm doing, what I'm drawing, how I draw it. If you're interested, I mean, it's really slow, so you pretty much get what I'm doing, but yeah, if you want to see more like this, just let me know. I have like a few drawings in your styles also recorded. I could make them also slower than usually. I want to, oh my gosh, I have so many things that I want to do. Guys, I'm really trying here to change it up a little bit, and I still need to, because I have still my 6th Fan Art Challenge that I am uploading. I have a ton of drawings and new styles that I will upload, sketchbook tours and so on, but I still want to differ it a little bit, like with this real-time video. I have something that I won't spoil it, you guys, but I really hope you will enjoy it as soon as I upload. Like, I have probably around at least 3 videos for you guys that will be a little bit different than this one, and I really hope you will enjoy it. And I'm just like, excited, a little bit like, I don't know how to call it. Like, I'm excited, but I'm like a little bit nervous. And I just really hope that it can help you guys, that you like it, and yeah, just I really want to relax with you guys, just make this little art corner a little bit bigger maybe and reach you, because of course I do art because I love it. I do art because I hope that I will get it to make it my job. And yeah, it's just like I never thought I would talk through this. Like, it seems I can. So maybe I will do more like this. Also maybe I will do more sketching. I could also make videos like practice, and in real time you can practice with me. Yeah, just let me know in the comments what would you like, and I hope you actually enjoy videos like this. Like, I'm really nervous because it's like, I don't even know. I uploaded something like this years ago, and I really hope you don't mind. I hope you liked seeing this really slowly inking and coloring of her. The most time took her skin, as you could tell. And yeah, I just really hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments, and if you want and see more art, then follow me on Instagram or Artamino. I have also Twitter, but I'm just like always forgetting to upload there. Like, you know, uploading on too many sites. Like, I still have my DeviantArt, and uploading on my Facebook also a little bit, even if I don't have a large following there. But it's a lot. But I will try my best. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please let me know in the comments, and if you want to see more like this, or also like still speed paints and everything, which I will upload, then subscribe for more, and hopefully I will see you then in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and see you then. Bye bye!